Reuben to call people very sharply, very strongly to the mat. Even Jesus, if you remember, made a whip of cord at one point. Now, that does not mean, it does not give us license to go in blasting with both barrels and dealing not out conscience with our words. It means that we correct very strongly, using the word of God to show them unflinchingly and in no uncertain terms how they are violating God's clear command. Paul says we are to exhort and convict by sound doctrine. The word translated sound means healthy, as opposed to sick teaching, which, for instance, puts the emphasis on man's ability or effort, that promotes, say, a separation between the Christian life and regular life, teachings which promote experience over reverence. Anything that would take away from the uniqueness and the superiority of Christ's salvation is unsound, unhealthy doctrine. The bottom line, brother, office bearers, is that we must be pointing every person, friend or foe, to the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ, of course, will be a stumbling block to some, and he will be a breath of fresh air to others. He will be the aroma of life to some, he will be the aroma of death to others. But we must present him as we exhort, as we convict, because this is our calling. Brothers, fellow office bearers, we thank the Lord for you this morning, and we entrust you into the hands of the great shepherd as you now take up the work of service. And we promise you our prayers, because we know that yours is not an easy task. We pray that you will continue to hold fast to the faithful word as you have been taught, and may God give you wisdom and strength as you encourage the sheep and challenge the wolf. May the holy name of Christ be exalted among us, and may his salvation be believed and proclaimed as we serve him together. Amen. Father in heaven, we thank you once again that you have not left the church without order, and that you have prevented and kept us from chaos and from apostasy by giving structure to the elders and the deacons. We thank you again for these men. We thank you for the dedication and the work of the elders and deacons in this congregation. And we pray that we would have your blessing as we go forward as office bearers and as a congregation to serve you in this house of prayer as we worship and in our daily life. We pray this in Jesus'
name. Amen. Number 443 is our song of response, Faith of Our Fathers. Let's rise to sing the three stanzas of number 443. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we give of our offerings this morning, we pray for your blessing upon our hearts, that we may willingly and cheerfully give to you but a small portion of what you have given to us. We thank you for the work of word and deed in a world where there are so many tragic things that happen, in a world where we take so much for granted, we eat so well, and there is no question of our children attending school and getting an education. There are many in the world who do not have these simple necessities, and so we pray that you would bless the work of word and deed and bless what we give toward the furtherance of their work. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. After we sing our doxology, if the elders and new deacon would be so kind as to stand in the middle of the gym maybe, and there you can offer your words of encouragement to them if you would so like. Congregation, lift up your hearts to heaven and receive the Lord's blessing as we part. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you his peace. Amen. Our final hymn of praise is stanza 4 of number 466.